Good morning, class 11C, and today we'll do the conclusion of the play Mother's Day. And as you all know from the things that we have discussed, can you just tell me who are the important characters in this play? Yes, who are the important characters in this play? We have Mrs. Fitzgerald and we have the family of Mrs. Pearson, right? Now, what has happened that Mrs. Pearson and Mrs. Fitzgerald, they have, or rather Mrs. Fitzgerald, she was there quite dominating and quite insisting about changing personality so that she could sit Mrs. Pearson's family, right, you know, make them more obedient and better, you can say, people. They should respect to their mother, they should understand, they should cooperate, and they should spend time at home. So what was the solution to this problem? Yes, let me see here. Who would like to answer? What was the solution to this? Yes, what was the solution here? And what was the family's reaction? Anybody would like to give the answer? Who would like to speak? Yes, Isha would like to tell me? Vanya? So what has happened here as a result of this change? That is, yeah, there's a lot of problem. Doris and Cyril are upset, and even George Pearson, he is quite upset to find his wife completely changed, and she's not obedient and not listening, and right, she's not paying any concern towards their feelings even, right? In fact, she's rude with her husband and tells him that you should go to this club where he goes less, and he should spend time with his family. And in fact, she even tells him that he teased, and people call him Ompy Pompy Pearson at the club. And yes, Mr. Pearson is very shocked with this revelation, and he does not know how to react and how to behave. He asks his son, and his son also says, yes, I think that is what they call you, and that is how they make fun of you, right? So now, what has happened? While all this confusion is going on, who comes? Mrs. Fitzgerald. And Mrs. Fitzgerald, who is she? She is Mrs. Pearson. And she's very surprised to see the condition of her family, because she has never been strict in her life. But now she notices that her family is in big problem. And she requests Mrs. Fitzgerald that please let us change back the, let us exchange the personality so that they will come to the original self, and the family would be back to normal. Okay, right? Now here, look at this. And one thing which has also been noticed is that how John and Cyril, they're quite rude with the neighbor. And Mrs. Pearson tells them that how they should behave. They should wish her, they should ask her to sit down, they should be polite, right? And yes, so here everyone is, they're quite scared of mother's behavior, and they all readily agree. Now let's continue. George and Doris exit left. As they go, Mrs. Fitzgerald moves to left of the small table and sits. She eagerly beckons Pearson to do the same thing. Mrs. Fitzgerald, we must change back now. We really must. Why? Because this has gone far enough. What has gone far enough? This exchange of personalities and the harsh treatment of my family. Okay? A bit more of the same would do him good, making a bit great difference already. She says, let me continue for some more time. And it is going to make more difference. Already a lot has been done, so we can carry on with it. She moves to the right of the table and sits. No, I can't stand any more of it. I really can't. We must change back. Hurry up, please, Mrs. Fitzgerald. So she is there, as we know that, yes, Mrs. Pearson is simple lady. She's not quite happy with that, and so she wants the personalities to be changed. Well, if you insist, yes, I do, please. She stretches her hand across the table eagerly. Mrs. Pearson takes him. Quiet now, relax. Mrs. Pearson, Mrs. Fitzgerald stare at each other, mustering exactly as before. They carry out the same action as before, going lax. Lax is like as if they appear to be lifeless and then coming back to life. But this time, of course, they come with their proper personality. So Mrs. Pearson, Mrs. Pearson and Mrs. Fitzgerald is once again her own personality, right? Ah, well, I enjoyed that. I didn't. Well, you ought to have done. Now listen, Mrs. Pearson, don't go soft on them again, please. Else it will all have been wasted. What does this mean? Don't go soft on them again. What do you think it means? Going soft on them means don't be lenient with them again, right? Otherwise, it will all have been wasted. What would have been wasted? Her strict behavior, the way she was there handling her family, how she's made them aware of certain things and made them realize that mother should not be taken for granted always. I'll try not to, Mrs. Fitzgerald. They have not had as long as I'd like to have given them. Another hour or two's rough treatment might have made it. I'm sure they'll do better now, though I don't know how I'm going to explain. Yes. Don't you start explaining or apologizing, or you're done for. So don't explain anything. Don't apologize for your rough behavior. Otherwise, once again, your family is going to be like that. They're going to be very lenient and casual. So at least now we have taught them a lesson. It's all right for you, Mrs. Fitzgerald. After all, they aren't your husband and children. It's okay for you. It's not your family. You can be strict with them, but they are my family. I can't be so harsh. I cannot be so strict with them. Now you listen to me. You admitted yourself you were spoiling them and they didn't appreciate you. Any apologies, any explanations, and you'll be straight back where you were. I'm warning you, dear. Just give them a look, a tone of voice, now and again, to suggest you might be tough with them if you wanted to be, and it ought to work. Anyhow, we can test it. So she says that carry on with this strict behavior. Be strict once in a while, and then they will continue listening to you, and you will have an obedient family. We can test it now. How? Well, what is it you'd like them to do that they don't do? Stop at home for once? Yes, and give me a hand with supper. See, the whole day I keep on working. So when they come back from home, if they can come and help me a little bit, I would really appreciate it. That is what she wants. Okay? Supper kya tha? Evening meal. Anything you'd like them to do that you enjoy, whether they do or not. So what else do you want them to do right with you? That is, well, yes, I like a nice game of rummy cards, but of course I hardly ever have one except at Christmas. So they don't play with me. They don't take out time for me. I would like it if they could help me with the cooking in the evening. I would like it if they would play a game of cards with me, not only on Christmas. That will do then. She moves towards the door, then turns left. But remember, key four, or you've had it. She opens the door calling. You can come in now. But remember, a firm hand. I'm just off to let you enjoy yourself. So Mrs. Pearson has gone and the family enters. The family looks anxiously at Mrs. Pearson, who smiles. Much relieved, they smile back at her because she's not smiled. She was very strict and lighter. So, and now the family is very happy. Oh God, thank God, mother is smiling. Yes, mother. Seeing that you don't want to go out, I tell you what I thought we'd do. Mrs. Fitzgerald, remember, giving a final warning, he's strict, nodding, then looking sharply. No objections, I hope. No, mother, whatever you say. I thought we'd have a nice family game of rummy, and then you children could get the supper ready while I have a talk with your father. So I'd like that you should all sit and have a nice game of cards together. And after that, you children can get the dinner ready while I'll have a talk with your father. Suits me. He looks challengingly at the children. What about you two? He's looking at them. You also should say yes. Yes, that's all right. Well, what? Speak up. Oh, I think it would be lovely. Goodbye, Mrs. Fitzgerald. Come again soon. Yes, dear. Night all. Have a nice time. Mrs. Fitzgerald exits left and the family cluster round mother as the curtain falls. So end of the play. So Mrs. Fitzgerald has given her a warning that you should be strict and you should deal with carry on in the strict behavior once in a while. And right now is the time to convince your family to spend time with you, to be with you. Okay. Now look at these questions. Can we discuss the questions? Any doubt you have? Any questions you would like? Anything not clear? Yes? Anyone? Any questions? Any doubts? No? So I can start with the question answers. Can I? Okay. Yes, so all of you, let's just have a look at the question. This play, written in the 1950, is a humorous and satirical depiction of the status of mother in the family. Right? Satire is what? What? With humor and irony, that you highlight an issue. So here with satire, let's see how the members of the family, they are not obedient, they're not cooperative, they are so selfish and they don't, you know, care about mother. So it's a very exaggerated situation. Okay, right. So what are the issues it raises? Now I want you people to wake up and give me the answers. So please, yes. What are the issues it raises? You can raise your hand. I can unmute you. You can text me your answers. Yeah. What are the issues this play raises? Yes. What is the most important issue? It is the status of the mother, the position of the mother in the family. Right? Have you read this play? Have you understood it? Yes, you have. So can you give me the answers now? Do you think it caricatures these issues or do you think that the problem it raises are genuine? Caricatures is, you know, like, has it been, you know, like humor presented? It has been exaggerated or it is really a situation that happens? So yes, definitely it is there, but sometimes things might not go to such an extreme as it is shown here in the play. How does the play resolve the issue? How are the issues resolved in this play? That is through exchange of personalities and mother becoming strict, right? So do you agree with the resolution? Well, yes, we do agree because naturally sometimes you have to be strict with your family members to make them understand that if you're working, you need to spend time at home also. You need to spend time with the family. You need to cooperate with mother. You should understand that she also needs time to rest. So she can't just keep on working nonstop for you all and not get any time off herself. If you were to write about these issues today, what are some of the incident examples and problems that you would think of as relevant? Yes, sir. Very important question. This is one issue that we talk about. If you were to highlight some of the issues today, what are the issues that you think would be relevant? And I want answers from you all. Come on. Yes, yeah. Let me see you all. Yes, come on. Give me answers, please. Yes, yes, yeah. Here. Come on. Let me see your answers. Yeah, if you were to write about these issues today, what are some of the incidents and examples and problems that you would think of as relevant? Amit would like to speak. Smriti, you'd like to give the answers? So is it only about, we can talk about the problem here of the position of the mother in the family, the status of mother in the family, or we can have a place highlighting other issues? Yes, Smriti, can you speak up, please? Any other issues you think that today we can talk about as relevant? Are you there? Yes, Smriti? Isha?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What are the issues?
Ma'am, what kind of issues? Is it related with the mother?
No, other issues here related to society? This is one problem that we have spoken about. What other issues can be there related to the mother? Yes? What other issues can be there related to the mother? What other issues are there? Yes, Navya would like to speak. Yes, Navya.
Ma'am, like only restricted to the household goals, not moving out of the house and not working out, just taking care of the children according to the society.
Okay, what else? What else? And because mother is always at home, she's always...
Ma'am, taking... not thinking about oneself, only about the household, children and family.
Yes. Right. So, and naturally, the mother, how can she, are there ways she can take care of her family better, how her family can cooperate? We have discussed this. Yes, Smriti? Yes?
Our mother sacrifices a lot for her family and she has to sacrifice her career also. This is a big opportunity for women.
Yes.
If they can't succeed, there is a big barrier.
Yes, it's a big barrier. And they give up on their dreams, they give up on this, their future, you know, career prospects, very rightly said. And they forget everything for the sake of their family, okay? And then, of course, unequal treatment in the family and everyone taking her for granted. This is one issue. Now, if we were to write about the issues that are today in our society, what issues can we highlight? Yes, anyone? What issues can we highlight? We'd like to play about these issues. We'd like to talk about problems that are in the society. What all can we talk about? So just like we have about the position of the mother in the family, can we talk about the position of women in society? Yes, can we have a discussion about this also? Anybody? So this is one example. Can you think of other examples for which we can talk about, issues that we can highlight? Can you talk about dowry? Yes. Can you talk about the education of the girl child? Right? Yes. So can you talk about exploitation at the workplace? If you're talking about at home, what about at the workplace also? Right? Yes. So can we talk about child labor? There are so many issues that we can talk about. Yes. Now you tell me. Now I have given you so many examples. Can you tell me now what are the issues, what problems we can talk about? Yes. Who would like to speak? Who would like to talk? Vanya? Isha? Yes? Anybody? I have discussed a few with you. Anything else you'd like to talk about? Is there any other issue you'd like to talk about? These are more than enough. Are they? Yes? Who'd like to speak? Just raise your hand if you want to. So these are there, you know, like certain issues, and there are many more that can be highlighted. There are many more issues that we can talk about through the medium of drama, right? Yes. So we talk about child labor. We can talk about stress among students here, about exam stress, about the pressure of performing well in exams, and about children also, because they are there, maybe because of what society expects from them, from what family expects from them, and sometimes they are there not doing what they want to do. So they are also sacrificing their dreams, they're sacrificing what they actually want to do, and because the society shows that this is right and this is wrong, as a result, we follow that pattern. So yes, so please, they can be used. There are many issues that we can highlight, okay? So this is one issue. There are other issues that need to be highlighted, right? Yes. Now, of course, here in this play, we can also know that her mother, she keeps on working for the family, but she does not take care of herself, how her health might suffer, how her dignity suffers, how her self-esteem suffers because of that, isn't it? Right? Yes. Yes, here I have a beautiful answer, and this is, yes, so mother has been issue, women harassment, women feeling unsafe, female feticide, And even now we have, we have our biases, that gender discrimination is still there. So plays can definitely talk about these issues. Yes. Now, is drama a good medium for conveying a social message? Discuss. So like this play, it was humorous also, and the characters behaving, their behavior, it might be typical of people in society. So was it a good medium for conveying a social message? How is drama a good medium? So when you see plays being enacted, how are they much better than just giving speeches and long lectures about an issue? How is it a better medium for conveying a social message? Can anybody tell me? Yes? How is it? So we laughed also, right? Yeah, when Doris and Cyril, they got this rough treatment, we were quite surprised when George comes to know that he's called a Pompey Pearson. Okay, right? So all these things here, and when they're enacted on stage, how the exchange of personality happens, how the confusion in the family takes place. So drama is a good medium because we are able to relate to it. We are able to see the people acting it out. And yes, those situations, they are quite similar to maybe what we have noticed in society, things that happen in our family, around us. So that is why, yes, social media messages are there. So in drama also, we have various forms of drama also, right? Yeah, so you have on the stage also, we have plays on the streets also, you have nukkad natas highlighting important messages. You know, it could be simple messages about sanitation, hygiene, right? It could be a simple message about obeying the traffic rules. So you have a nukkad natak relating that. People listen to it. And not many people pay attention to the posters which are there. People don't even pay attention to the traffic lights, right? They are so careless. But yes, so we have here drama, plays. They are a very good medium of conveying a social message, right? So through enactment, through, you know, like, yes, the dialogues, and through the scene enactment, we are able to convey this message properly, okay? Right. Then we have here, read the play out in parts, enact the play on a suitable occasion. Any occasion where you would like to enact this play? Yes? Any occasion, right? So not necessarily on Mother's Day, it could be any time when we could highlight this issue, okay? Now, can you discuss here about plays or films with a strong message of social reform that you have watched? So nowadays, we have a lot of movies which are talking about social reforms, about changes which need to be introduced in society. Any thing you would like to talk about? Any play you've read about? Any book you have read? Any movie you have seen which talks about conveying a social message? So, right, there are so many movies there which are talking about social issues. We talk about movies talking about drugs, we talk about gender discrimination, we talk about the law and order, all these things which are there, and all of them are there conveying a message, okay? Right, so with this we have come to an end of this play. And all things are not over yet. I'll be sharing with you question answers. Yes, extra questions here. This is just for your discussion, which is here. But I'll be giving you more text-based questions, and we can do those questions here. Okay. So I expect you to make a notebook and do your questions over there. Make sure that your writing skills are also there in that notebook, which you had previously, so you'll be continuing your work over there. Any doubts, any questions regarding this? Is there any doubt you have? Any questions?